Got a new chit chat here ready with me. I want to talk about some things that's been going on and some new products that I have. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and stay tuned. Okay, y'all, I'm starting off with a bare face. I've already done basically my, if I'm looking over here, I'm looking at the viewfinder just to make sure that it doesn't cut off on me like last time. So if you see me looking over here, y'all know exactly what it is. But I've already done my eyes, put my eyelashes on, and I've also already done my eyebrows. The eyelashes that I have on were just some eyelashes from like Amazon or eBay. I don't remember. So nothing special. You can find them anywhere. And I did use for my eyes the Masquerade Mini Palette by Juvia's Place. Speaking of Juvia's Place, that's the foundation that I've really been wanting to try lately. So we're gonna see how that goes. I'm gonna go ahead and prime my face with the Too Faced Hangover RX Primer, Replenishing Face Primer. And I'm just gonna rub that all over my face. And this is very moisturizing. I really like this for the summertime because as of lately, I've been using a retinoid on my face and so it dries my face out. So if you have dry skin, I definitely would suggest this because it's very moisturizing. It feels really good on the face. And I'm just gonna let that sit for a minute. And while that sits, I did wanna talk to y'all about something because I have been loving this product and I know I haven't been on YouTube in a while. It is the Super Goop Glow Stick Sunscreen. I just wanna put it on so y'all can just see. Like, look at this. Okay. For all my darker skin ladies, y'all already know that sometimes when we put on sunscreen, we get that little white mask. This does not do that, and it adds like such a pretty glow on the skin, and it's SPF 50. Another thing a lot of people don't know about this too is I think this is like $20-something, $25. But if you go to Super Goop's website, not sponsored or anything, this is just what I know from doing it. If you have an HSA card for all my people that have, you know, their benefits, you can get all your SPF for free. So anything on their website, you type in your HSA card information and you can get everything for free. So I would definitely suggest not paying cash for this. Put it on your HSA sunscreen is covered. That is something that's covered by your insurance, depending on who you have. So I think I'm pretty primed. I'm gonna go ahead and use ColourPop's. This is also a new product, but it's all rubbed off. I'm sorry, it's been in my purse. ColourPop's Lip Plumping. Why can I say that? Lip Plumping. There we go. What is this? Gloss, and it's like a high pink color. I don't know, I apologize. I don't know what color this is. It's really pretty. And that way my lips don't look so dry while we're filming and everything. And just to go ahead and mattify some parts, like my T-zone where I get really oily, I'm gonna use the Becca Ever Matte Poreless Priming Primer. And I'm gonna use this on my forehead, my cheeks, and my chin, just right there. Those are the spots I get really oily, like right in here, girl, like right between my eyelash, on top of my nose, but everywhere else, I'm fine. T-zone, like for real. I know so many girls have the same issue with women, girls, boys, everybody. So I'm gonna let that sit for a while. So I've been really wanting to try the Juvia's Place Foundation and I promise, yeah, I know I'm late, but I promised that I was gonna do a review on it. So this is it right here. I picked it up at Ulta, which I was kind of disappointed that every Ulta is not carrying this foundation. So I had to go to Ulta that was kind of far from me, like maybe 25 minutes away to get this color. I was in the store, y'all, for like 45 minutes trying on all the foundations, trying to figure out exactly what color or shade I was. And there were like 3 or 4 foundations that I felt like would work for me. And I tried to walk around the store without seeming like, you know, like a little creep or suspicious or anything to let them sit on my face and see how they looked after they set. And it was like 3 different ones, but I chose a 410 Nairobi, although I think I probably could have chose a different one, but we're gonna try this one out and y'all give me your opinion in the comment box below about what you think. But speaking of Juvia's Place, oh my gosh, there's been so much drama in the beauty community. I know y'all are tired of beauty community drama. I am. From the Jaclyn Hill lipsticks to the Jeffree Star to the James Charles to the Tati. Everybody, it's just been so crazy. And I'm like, what happened to the good old days when we just cared about makeup? Like, I just literally want to know about makeup. It's like sometimes I feel like we're all about everything but beauty in the beauty industry. So I think I should use a brush with this. And I know a lot of my sisters are probably looking at me like, girl, why are you using Juvia's Place? We canceled them. But the thing is, okay, let me give y'all the background on what happened with Juvia's Place. I'm just gonna dot this. I know this is really thick. I don't know how this is gonna go. So we're just gonna go with the flow with this. And maybe I should spray my face, huh? I'm gonna use the Hangover 3-in-1 Replenishing Primer Setting Spray, and I'm just gonna spray it on my face. This is already in my eyes. I don't wanna like mess anything up, so I just barely spritzed it on my face. But Juvia's Place, not too long ago, two really well-known YouTube beauty gurus that are African-American kind of called them out because I guess they were kind of neglecting their African-American audience for a while, and they were using like a white beauty guru who is huge, and I mean totally huge, and I love her, watch her. I don't want to really call names because I just feel like there's no point. I'm just going to spread this around a little bit to try to cover up my spots. I mean, it looks pretty good. I mean, this looks crazy right now, but I'll blend that, but this looks pretty good. I don't know anything about that, so I kind of stayed clear of all of that. So I'm gonna let that sit a little bit, and I'm gonna go ahead and, yeah, let's go ahead and contour so I don't look like a big orange egg right now. We're gonna use the L'Oreal Infallible Longwear Shaping Stick in the color, what color is this? 412 Espresso. So I guess he had, reviewed Juvia's Place's foundation, and Juvia's Place got on Instagram. The owner got on Instagram and was like, oh my God, thank you. Like, shout out to Jeffree Star. We're so happy. They put it on their Instagram, and a lot of people were upset about that because, the racist remarks Jeffree Star has made in the past, and they didn't understand why a African-American company would be basically supporting him and why they were so excited that he had reposted their products. I mean, these products, Juvia's Place did not send him these products. He like went out and bought the product. So I didn't understand why people were mad, but I did kind of understand because they were so excited about Jeffree Star doing it. It's very hard to understand, but still, it wasn't enough for me to cancel Juvia's Place. I just feel like what's important to me may not be important to you, and what's important to you may not be important to me, so you have to kind of figure out where you stand on different issues. I do think that Juvia's Place definitely can handle their issues a little bit better via social media. And they shouldn't even, handle issues on social media, okay? But I do think that they can handle themselves better and be better as far as that. And I do feel like they should be way more connected to the black beauty gurus that are really popular right now and work on their relationships with them. And I definitely feel like it was a miscommunication, but I'm not going to cancel Juvia's Place. I feel like a lot of people get so up in arms about canceling people, like they want to cancel because this company has, Morphe, like all these other products that you use, they've also, Too Faced, they've also worked with Jeffree Star too. Sorry, my computer shut off on me, so. But what I was saying is, why would I cancel a small black business? Why would I cancel them? I shouldn't cancel them if I'm not gonna cancel other companies like Morphe and Too Faced and Tarte, unless you're willing to go all the way and cut off all these brands, you're not gonna have nothing to put on your face anyways. If you cut off every brand that did something bad, girl, you're not gonna have nothing to put on your face. But I can't be mad. I'm not gonna be mad about every little thing. Okay, that's looking a little better. I'm still looking like a little orange peel, but we're gonna fix that. I'm gonna go ahead and use the Born This Way multi-use sculpting concealer in the color Butterscotch, and I'm just gonna put this underneath my eye. But anyways, yeah, it's been so much drama, y'all, in the beauty community, and I'm like, let's just get back to makeup. Please, let's just get back to makeup. But I don't even want to talk about that right now. Let's talk about something else. So as y'all know, I got engaged earlier this year, and if one more person asked me when I'm getting married, I'm gonna scream. Y'all, when I tell y'all, it is so expensive to have a wedding. Like, now I know why people just elope or have international, like, go to a destination wedding, because it's way cheaper. Anything basically that has the word wedding in it is gonna cost you a couple grand just for the word wedding. It is so expensive. So unfortunately, my family is not able to pay for the wedding. You know, usually the bride's parents pay for the wedding. Unfortunately, that's not my case. So we have to save for our wedding. So it's gonna take us a little bit longer, especially because of the wedding that I want to use. Also, this sponge, y'all, is from Shop Miss A. It is so freaking soft, y'all. It is like the best sponge I've ever seen. Okay, guys, so where was I? Okay, so we were talking about, sorry, my fiance's coming in and out. We were talking about getting ready for the wedding and everybody asking me, and it's so nerve-wracking because it's like, I don't know what to say when people are like, okay, so where are you with the wedding planning? We're still saving. We're nowhere with the wedding planning. We haven't even begun to look for a wedding planner because we want to have our finances all in order. So that way, when they come at us like, you need a couple grand for this and that and this, because I already know, like, I know my standards. My fiance knows my standards. We know our wedding's going to be expensive. Like, I'm not even interested in doing some type of thrift budgeted wedding. I always dreamed of this moment. It's a big deal for me, so we already like understand like we're gonna have to save, and we're doing it on our own. So yeah. Next, I want to use the Jouer. I'm just gonna use a little bit of this because it is so thick. This concealer right here in Rich Ginger Jouer. I'm using this concealer, and I'm just gonna dot just a little bit. It's a heavier concealer, y'all. This is like full duty concealer. Like, this is craziness. I'm just gonna use a little bit of that underneath the eye before I sit. But yeah, so did any of y'all buy the Jaclyn Hill lipsticks? I was really shocked with that, but like, once again, you never know what's going on behind the scenes. You never know what, you know, exactly happened in with the manufacturer. I don't know. Everybody's like, she's lying. I don't know if she's lying. I don't know that lady. Y'all don't know if she's lying either. We don't know her. I'm gonna use the, you don't know her personally. I'm gonna use the Dermablend Loose Setting Powder, and this one is in Cool Beige. So yeah, I'm gonna use that. But yeah, you don't know that lady, so stop trying to act like you do. And just say what she might have been thinking. You don't know what she was thinking. You don't. And I'm gonna go ahead and press my powder on all the spots where we just sit with the concealer. But you don't know her intentions. Oh, we can only hope that her intentions were pure. A lot of people, I feel like, put a lot of pressure on her for her products to be perfect. Like, they're so mean to her. They're just ready for everything to be wrong. Like, when her what was that, her Morphe collaboration came out, I actually really liked it. I didn't have an issue with her eyeshadow palettes. They worked really good to me. That's my opinion, but you know, I don't know. Some people were like, no, they were horrible, whatever. Okay, so another new product that I have is the Kylie Jenner Tawny Mommy bronzer. Look how pretty that is, y'all. So gorgeous. Love, love, love. This is so pretty. I'm gonna use a brush to go ahead and do a little contouring around my forehead and everything. And being engaged has been like pretty good. Of course, y'all see, I dyed my hair. I don't know if y'all can tell, but yeah, I dyed my hair, and I know everybody's like, you're natural. Don't dye your hair. Your hair is gonna fall out. Y'all, my hair is still here. It still looks the same as it was before. I can say though, it did change my texture, made my curls a little bit looser when I dyed my hair, but I have no regrets about dyeing my hair. Like, I'm so happy that I went ahead and I dyed it. Like, I'm so happy that I did, because everybody was telling me, do not do it. And I did, and I'm happy about it. But I'm so happy it's summertime, but now I'm kind of like one of those people like, dang, it is hot, okay? It is very hot, and I'm regretting wishing for the sun. I don't know if y'all are in Texas, then y'all already know. If you're somewhere else, then you might be very thankful. So I'm going to go ahead and use another new product. This is the ColourPop Pressed Powder Cheek Blush in the color. Does it have the color on here? It doesn't have the color on here, y'all. I don't know, but I think it's like the darkest one that they had. It doesn't have the color, but this is the color. It's really pretty. Y'all know I like my mauves and my berries, and I like blush, so I'm just going to go ahead and do that. Sorry, I gotta be quiet when I put on my blush. Chai is having a really good time, so if you need a spooky toy, my fiance let her in here, and now she will not be quiet. She wants to say hi, clearly. See, y'all, I'm looking in the viewfinder. My face is slowly coming together. Now I'm gonna use my favorite setting powder. It's the Sephora Micro Smooth in the color Deep. I think they still sell this. Don't know if they do. Every time I'm like, I don't know. They say they're gonna cancel it, then they say they're not, and they say it's like something else. I still have the same one. I haven't hit pan on it, but I'm getting close, and I don't know what I'm gonna do, but it just makes my face look so airbrushed. Chai. Please. Sorry. Okay, y'all. I had to kick Chai out of the room. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm trying to get back in the hang of recording again. It's been a while. I'm just going to warm up my face even more because I feel like that Kylie Jenner bronzer really didn't bring too much. I want like that really like sun-kissed bronze glow. Like, I want to be dark around, you know, make my face look smaller too. So I'm going to use the Milani Earth Glow Pressed Powder, y'all. This stuff is only like $7. I heard how good it was. Everybody was raving about it, and it reminds me of the CoverGirl Clean Collection. What was that one everybody loved? It reminds me of that. Look how pretty that color is. Oh, gorgeous. Love it, love it, love it. So I'm just going to go around and frame my face and bronze a little bit more with this. But yeah, I feel like I'm on here and I don't know what to talk to you guys about. It's been so long. I you know, of course we can talk about YouTube beauty drama all day. Really, I don't even really have much to say about it. It's like, you have to figure out what you do and don't agree with, and who and you will and won't support, and what brands and companies feel like they cater to you and what you're about. And you can't, we're so like in this cancel culture. We want to cancel everybody and everything. And I feel like you can't just cancel everybody and everything as soon as they do something you don't like. Like, you have to kind of figure it out, work with them. Not saying that these people are innocent, not saying, you know, that they didn't do anything. If you did something bad, you definitely deserve to get a talking to and get corrected. But I'm just so happy back when I was growing up, social media wasn't so huge, because y'all, if you knew the things that I was saying at 16, 14, I would probably be canceled too. I mean, it's just part of growing up. Like, you learn what you can and can't say to people. You learn all that. I have that. How do y'all think the foundation looks now? See, it looks a little better now. At first I looked like a big orange circle, but it does look a little better. I'm gonna go ahead and move in. We bronzed, we've done our powder and all of that jazz. I'm gonna do my highlighter, which is my favorite part. I'm gonna use the Dose of Colors Desi Katie collection in the color Mirame. This is a little bit lighter, so I am going to go over it with another highlighter, but I really think this is really pretty. And I'm just going to hit with a fan brush the top to my cheeks. I don't know if y'all can see it. Can you see that glow? It's like subtle. It looks really natural. That's why I like it. It's really pretty. If you look at it, it looks like, will that work for me if I'm darker skin? A little bit on my forehead and right here, but it just adds like a nice little shine, like especially if you're dry skin, like if you have dry skin, then I think you'll really like this, because it adds like that J-Lo wet look to your face. It's so pretty. I'm doing a little bit above my lip. Y'all, I'll be dipped. I love highlighter, okay? I will be dipped in highlighter. You gotta tell me to stop. Like, I don't know when to stop. I'm gonna then go in with the Makeup Shayla ColourPop Collection Loose Highlighting Powder in the color Pose. It looks like this. And I'm just gonna use a little bit of that. I can't find my other highlighting brush, so I'm just gonna have to use this and barely tap it because it's very loose and it gets messy. I'm just barely gonna hit my brush on it, and I'm gonna tap a little bit over that to add a little bit more glow and bring it to a more bronzy color. Do y'all see how pretty that is? Oh, ooh, yes, it's so pretty, y'all. And it just adds that summertime glow. Looks like I'm sweating a little bit, but not like nasty, like pretty gold sweat. And I'm gonna just kind of hit my, what is this called? What do they call this? Collarbone? I'm gonna hit that too, just cause I have a shirt on that has it showing. You know, be a little extra for the summertime, add a little glow, yes. And one thing I didn't finish is I did not finish doing my under eye. So I did like all of this, set my brows, all of that jazz, but I didn't do my under eye, so I'm gonna do that with you guys on film. Once again, I'm using the Masquerade Mini Palette by Juvia's Place. It looks like this. It's just pretty. I cannot cancel Juvia's Place, y'all. I'm sorry. And I'm gonna use like an angled brush. Let's see. Where's my little brush? I can't find the one I normally use, but I'll go ahead and use this one. And the colors that I used for this eye look was this one, Zobo, Calabar, Ada, and Fulani. So I'm gonna go back with Zobo. And I'm just gonna go underneath my waterline just to connect the top to the bottom to make it all mesh well together. So pretty, y'all. Oh, so gorgeous. They're so pigmented. Like, I just want everybody to get it right and stop fighting and stop, stop being messy. Get off the social media and get back to like your passion of makeup or beauty, whatever it is you wanna do, is just concentrate on that. Like, we shouldn't have time for no drama, like no drama at all. And just in the corner of my eye, y'all, I'm going to use the shimmer color Calabar, which is also the color I have right here on the inner eye. I'm just going to wipe my brush off, and then I'm gonna switch into this like little fluffy Morphe M149 brush, which you can find at Ulta now. It's cheaper, you don't have to pay shipping and handling, and I'm gonna just dab that right into my tear duct. Ugh, like you barely have to touch it. It's so pretty, so pretty. But I do have some things planned, y'all. I do wanna get back. I always say this, and I know y'all are like, it is very hard to be consistent because, you know, I just have these moods and I just go through, like, sometimes I'm really happy, sometimes I'm not too happy. You know, it's just an up and constant down with me. But just stay with me. I promise y'all I'm going to get better at being consistent. But if you don't follow me on Instagram or Twitter, you definitely should, because I'm way more active on those two platforms than I am, especially on Twitter. I love Twitter. It's freaking hilarious. Black Twitter. They're funny. That's my family. Like, I can laugh at everything that they say. Oh my gosh. So to do the bottom lashes, I don't have anything on my bottom lashes and I kind of want them to pop, I'm going to use the Too Faced Damn Girl mascara. I got a little travel size of this just to try it out. And I'm just going to go ahead. I can't talk when I do this, y'all, so it's going to be kind of silent and awkward. I'm going to go ahead and do my bottom lashes. I'm going to use the Hard Candy Wet Ever Bold Hold Liquid Lip Gloss in the color Genius. This is very sticky, but it's such a pretty color. If you do not like sticky, you are not going to like this, girl. I'm not even going to front. It also came with a lip liner, but that really didn't do much the last time I tried. I guess I can try again. I'm going to wipe this lip plumper off of my lips just so you can have a clean base to start with. Yeah, see, you can't even really see it, y'all. But this came in a set at Walmart. I think it was like $7. And I had originally bought it for my niece, and she didn't want it, so She's not really that into makeup, so I took it for myself. Let's see how this looks. Okay, this is really thick and sticky, so once again. But look how pretty that is. What is that? Is that hair, y'all? Did I have hair the whole time stuck to my lip? Y'all, having a pet, you find pet hair every freaking where. Look how pretty it is. Oh! It just makes it seem like you like got your lips done or something. It's just so pretty. But I do think I need a darker lip liner. Candy by ColourPop. Here it is right here. It's like a brown color. I'm just going to kind of outline my lips a little bit just to, you know, make it blend in a little better. Let's see how this goes. Yes. Go ahead and set with the Morphe Setting Continuous Mist. I'm just going to spray my face from far away so I don't mess anything up. I'm going to keep my eyes open so my mascara doesn't run. Okay. That is so pretty. What do y'all think? Anyways, I missed y'all so much. I can't wait to create more content for you guys. I'm so happy to be filming again. And just stay tuned. Make sure you subscribe. I know y'all saw the new intro video. I hope you really, really like it. But until next time, stay positive, stay beautiful, and stay you.